Hi everybody, welcome back to Studio Sam. Today I have got, I'm going to open up the bag of shopping that I bought yesterday at the craft fair and show you what I got, because I got some really cool stuff that I really like. So the first thing I got, I needed a new quilting ruler. I'm planning on starting a new quilt sometime soon. In fact, I've already started chopping out the pieces for it, and I've never had a really good quality ruler, so I got one of those. And the next thing I found, I think you would have seen it in the video I made yesterday where I showed you around the craft show with us, was these velvet colouring in pictures. They are just so lovely. I was looking at them, and a lot of them were just like mandalas and animals, which were cute, but I wouldn't buy them. And as I was about to walk away, I looked back, and then I saw that they had these Vincent ones with the Vincent van Gogh pictures, and I just love everything Vincent. So I went back and I bought the Starry Night one for me, and I bought the Sunflowers one for my girl Alice to do. So the black part here is actually velvet, and the white part is the part that you colour in. There is an example of the picture that they have got pre-coloured. Actually, there's a better example of that picture on the back there. And so it came with some textures as well. Like, it actually came with a packet of textures. These are just everyday, like, kind of kid style ones, so I don't actually think I'm going to use the textures that they gave for free with the kit. I'm going to use my Copic markers. They said you can use anything to colour in the areas, and they said they've seen some artists do them with watercolours, so that would look really nice too. But I think I'm just going to use my Copic markers on this, so I might do a video, like a time lapse when I do that. Hey pups, you want to come up? Come on. Astro's going to join me. Okay, you sit there and be good, okay? You're going to be a good boy? All right. So the next thing that I bought is the Chula Pink fabrics. I'll show you those. Okay, so I bought some Chula Pink fabrics. I got like 5 or 6 of her fat quarters. Sometimes just with the fabric designers, Chula Pink is like a fabric designer that has come along and has just kind of blown my mind. When everybody else is kind of doing same, similar things, just these wild colours and these beautiful prints just make me so happy. So look at these, honestly. That's the little squirrel one. Just some plain spots. Beautiful birds and flowers, and here's another little squirrels. So lovely, they're just so beautiful. I don't know what I'm going to do with those yet, but I'm going to stick them away and keep them in the back of my head for something will come up. Mermaid kit! Look at this sweet little mermaid kit. This is a sweet little stitching kit I bought from a company called Fifi's Fabricology. I think they're online. I think they've got a good website online you can buy things from. So it's just so cute. You stitch this little mermaid yourself. So the kit comes with everything you need to make it. It's got the fabric that you need. It's got like some fusible webbing, great illustrations and diagrams for the pictures, and everything you need is in there. So I just thought it was just so adorable. I just had to get that. I'm not sure where it's going to go yet either. Diamond painting! So did you see yesterday when I was showing you around the craft show, there was one company called makeitmosaic.com.au. So they're an Australian company, and they were the only people I saw yesterday that had those rhinestone paintings. A lot of people who are doing the regular diamond paintings. There was actually quite a few companies there with diamond paintings, but these are the only guys that had the rhinestone, that real shiny, like glittery crystal rhinestone diamond paintings. So I couldn't let this go. I bought the mermaid image one, and I also bought the unicorn one. However, the little unicorn was sold out because yesterday on Sunday when I went, it was the last day of the show, so they had sold out of the unicorn. So I paid for it and they're going to post it to me with free postage. So I thought that was really lovely. But this little mermaid is going to be so lovely. So it comes with the frame as well. And of course, all the lovely rhinestones. So I'm thinking, it's only just after 10 o'clock here, I'm thinking if I do a little bit of housework, tidy up a little bit, get done what I have to get done, I'm going to sit down and do that today, because I don't think it'll take me that long. So I'll open that kit and do a little video of that, just this one. It cost a little bit more than a normal diamond painting. It's a 20 by 15, but I bought it anyway just because it comes with the free frame in there, which means that it's a done deal. I don't have to have it sitting, you know, on my shelf unframed. I can put it straight up somewhere, and it would make a beautiful present if you did that and could give it to somebody framed like that. So I just thought that was really lovely. Gonna be a good boy. Next thing I bought is this fabric panel. And this was from the company, the business called Mercia. And you can find them on Instagram and Facebook everywhere. And they are a supplier of beautiful craft. Their store, I think it was the prettiest, most beautiful stall at the whole show. I was just amazed at all the beautiful kits that they had. They had a lot of stitching kits for making your own like little soft toys. Gorgeous little cats and bunnies and rabbits, a little cat with a little raincoat on, with fish. It was just adorable. I knew I wasn't going to do one of those anytime soon, so I didn't get a kit, but I might in the future. But what I did get was this fabric panel. Oh my goodness. So I think a lot of you will probably be familiar with the Gorgeous Girls, which is made by the Santoro company in London. And so this is their new fabric panel that they've released. Oh, it's just so beautiful. As soon as I saw it, I knew I had to take it. On the stall, they had used this square here and made it into a book covering. Like they had used some kind of like probably a gel medium or fabric glue and glued it down onto the cover of a hard covered book. And it just looks so lovely. So I bought this fabric panel home and I'm going to come up with something crafty to use it for. Look, they are so lovely. So there are 8 squares in this panel. And it is the same 2 characters repeated in different colorways. Oh, that is lovely in the square. That is the square version, just in slightly different colorways. So gorgeous. I think that would be beautiful to use. Maybe I should use it to cover like an art journaling book or something similar. Next is my elusive Tula Pink rotary cutter. This is something that I saw. It came up on either Facebook or Instagram months ago, and I was just like, oh my goodness, what is that? That is just so beautiful. So I've had it in my head, and I thought when I was going to the show yesterday, if there was one thing that I would love to find at a craft show, it would be the Tula Pink rotary cutter. And I found it, I can't believe it. So it is like the KitchenAid of rotary cutters. It is anodized aluminium, so it is shiny and purple and sparkly and just beautiful. Don't ask me how much I paid for this amazing rotary cutter because it is more than I ever thought that I would pay for a rotary cutter. But as soon as I saw it, I knew that I could not walk out of there and leave it sitting on, leave it sitting at the shop, the stall, when I had been dreaming about it for so long. So she came home with me, and I will pay it off over the next few months. But anyway, it is beautiful. I'll show you a little bit closer up. But like I said, it's like the, to me, this is like the KitchenAid of rotary cutters. I'm hoping that I will probably have this for the rest of my life. I won't need to buy another one. And it's just so beautiful. I don't know if that camera is catching just how shiny and sparkly it really is. It's so lovely. And so unlike normal rotary cutters, this one, the safety switch is simply, it just retracts. It retracts that bit of plastic there, so that the blade is safe. It doesn't actually move the blade, which is really clever. And I'm presuming it just takes the normal size blades that every other rotary cutter takes. So I am so happy that I found that. I love it. You being a good boy? Say hi to everybody. This is Astro, our long-haired sausage. Next, I bought this little stitching pattern. This is from the same stall that I bought the fabric panel from. This is a gorgeous little quirky cat stitching pattern. So her name is Felicity, and this pattern comes with all the instructions and the templates and the pattern that I need to create this beautiful little stitching. So I'm thinking that I'm going to do it on a bit of fabric and just hang it as like an embroidery hoop stitchery kit. That's my plan. I just thought that was so cute, I couldn't let it go. Okay, I think that's it. So it is a freezing cold day here in Sydney today, so it is the perfect day for me to do this little kit. So after I get a little bit of housework done, just so I feel like I'm on top of stuff, I am going to sit down, open this up, and complete this one today. It's only a 20 by 15, so I don't think it should take me too long. I think I can probably get it done today. So I'll set up my camera, and I might do like one of those time-lapse videos to show you how we go. And to show you, because it's a rhinestone, it's quite different, and I haven't seen many of these around. So I'll do that with you guys today. Okay, that's it guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you had fun coming around the craft show with me on Sunday. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new, so that you can get regular crafty updates from me. And if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Thanks guys, see you later.